Alright guys, you are welcome. It's Unitech Solutions again. I'm Dawood Iddris. Now in this course, I'm going to teach you hypertext markup language. In our previous course, we looked at command prompt. Now, if you didn't take part in the command prompt as a course, please, you really need to do that. Now, after this presentation, you would understand the way in which HTML is used. You would appreciate the use of single page application as a modern method. You will be able to differentiate between HTML and SVG. But before that, let's look at the relationship between HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Now, from this course, we will be visiting cascading style sheet, which is CSS. Now, what is HTML? The relationship between HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML is the visual layer which includes text, images, videos, and etc. that the person see looking at the browser. Now, CSS, which is cascading style sheet, helps you position your web page, your HTML element. So, CSS set the display rules and other types of rule for HTML. Now, JavaScript, on the other hand, can change any of the two mentioned above at any time. So JavaScript, you can call a function and then it would change the look of CSS, the look of HTML in the web browser. Now you would ask, how does HTML works? Now what HTML does is that the browser sends a request to the server asking for a complete web page. Example, like home.html. Now the server, on the other hand, sends the web page back to the browser. The browser displays the entire web page for the user. Now this is how HTML works over 15 years plus ago, and it still remains the same. Now what single page application has brought to the market now is that instead of the browser requesting for the entire page from the server, it's request for a small piece of data from the server. So first, when you run your web page, when you request for the web page, it fetch everything for you. Now the subsequent request that you would make would be only requiring small piece of data. Example is to be changing the content aspect, but not the entire aspect of the web page. Now when we keep on using HTML, when we further up this course into details, you would understand how HTML really works. Now let's look at HTML and SVG, hypertext markup language and scalable vector graphics. Now you would ask me a question, whether there is a substitute, whether there is an alternative or an alternate for HTML, and I'm going to say yes, because you can use scalable vector graphics to create a web page also. But scalable vector graphics is a graphical approach, as the name applies, and it has small libraries. Now HTML is a text approach, also has a bit graphics and has many libraries. So what do I mean by them having libraries? The difference between their libraries is that when, let's say, you want to create a mobile application, definitely you are going to go in for HTML as compared to scalable vector graphics. So guys, in our next presentation, we are going to explore more about HTML.